Welcome back. This is Richard Walker from Lucidate, and this is the second in our series of automatic document generation using large language models. In the first installment of this series, we saw how we were able to use RAG, Retrieval Augmented Generation, to build a document from source materials that are often underutilized or even discarded. The first video highlighted two key points. Firstly, how generative AI can act as an alchemist in document production by turning the lead of meeting minutes, chat logs, and email threads into the gold of quality analytics and research reports. Secondly, how we can use RAG to train our LLM on material that was not part of its training corpus. In the first video, we used vector databases to introduce our style guide and some source material. In this video, we will focus on two additional things. Firstly, how adaptable this approach is, how it can not just be used for analysis and report production, but for a whole host of other generative language tasks too. Secondly, how to design this app to be used on mobile devices and how to deploy it to cloud servers such that it can be accessed not just on desktop browsers, but on tablets, phones, and other mobile devices. In our first video, we looked at how to create an analyst report from meeting minutes, email threads, and chat logs, source material that contains valuable information but is often thrown away. This analyst report contains a summary headline, attribution to the author, a series of multi-paragraph sections, each summarized with a relevant headline, and finally a disclaimer, an important compliance information. When we drag in our source material, the output follows not just this style, but also the tone of voice in the original article. But what if we wanted a different type of document? What if we wanted a press article or news summary? In this case, we might want shorter, crisper sections with a single paragraph, each with its own summary subheading that summarizes that particular paragraph. This would allow the reader to skim through the article to get to the gist. All we need to do to accomplish this is change the style guide and drag this into the application. Our source material here is identical, but we've totally changed the style, tone, and voice of the resulting AI-generated document. Now, there are myriad use cases that we can identify for this application, a small set of which are shown on your screen. From press releases to policy briefs, from product launch materials to marketing and SEO services. There are a whole host of documents that we can benefit from. The application can produce a high-quality first draft that can be edited and refined, or indeed a client-ready copy. It all depends on the quality of the input documents. Taking our application mobile isn't just convenient, it's transformative. Here we're deploying on Streamlit's cloud services to make your insights available anywhere, anytime. Let's dive into how you can launch this powerful tool onto Streamlit servers, ensuring that it's mobile ready for all your needs. To ensure your application is Streamlit ready, you'll need to create a repo on GitHub that you can later deploy to Streamlit. This code, which is available to Lucidate YouTube members at the CEO and managing director levels, is designed with flexibility in mind and thrives in both desktop and mobile environments. If you recall from the first video, it contains four key components implemented as Python classes. The first is the document processor, which strips out all of the text from supplied documents. The second is a vector store manager, which vectorizes this text and stores it in a vector database. The third component is the UI code for handling configuration, prompts, and supplying the necessary style and source documents. And finally, the article generator class, which uses our large language model, our prompt, and our RAG doc store to generate our article for us. Now, let's focus on the critical component for mobile deployment, the document processor. This class showcases an approach to universal design. The get text method here is a masterpiece of adaptability. Whether you're running locally on your computer or on somebody else's computer in the cloud, the process remains seamless. Upon receiving a PDF file, this class temporarily stores the file using a temp file. This is where the magic happens. Regardless of where the app runs, this method smartly handles the file, extracting the text without a hitch. In a local environment, the temporary file simply lives on your machine. On the cloud, it's on your hosting services servers. But to our document processor class, it makes no difference. It works flawlessly and identically, ensuring your PDFs are processed accurately, ready for insight extraction. Deploying to Streamlit is straightforward. After pushing your code to your own GitHub repository, simply link it to Streamlit's hosting service. With a few clicks, your application is live, transforming your mobile device into a powerhouse of knowledge extraction and document generation. As we've seen today, the power of generative AI and document generation is boundless. From enhancing communication to democratizing information, the potential is only limited by our imagination. Join us on this journey of discovery and innovation. Subscribe to our channel, like this video if you found it insightful, and share it with your peers. For Lucidate YouTube members at the managing director and CEO levels, exclusive access to the source code and detailed tutorials on deploying this application await. Don't miss out on our next video, where we'll explore how to leverage AI agents in RAG to fetch real-time data from the internet, further enhancing the richness of your documents. Until then, keep pushing the boundaries of what's possible. Together, let's redefine the future of document generation.